Hi, my name is Eric Cutlip, and I welcome you to the Royale ROS2 video tutorial. For the tutorial setup, I've got an Ubuntu 20.04 desktop. Connected, I have a Flex2 USB camera, and I also need the Royale SDK. For required software packages, I'll need to install ROS2 Foxy, as well as the Colcon build tool. For this video, I've already installed ROS2 Foxy and the Colcon build tool, so we can get started right away. So what will we build in this video? The first will be a ROS2 camera node. The node will use the Royale C++ library to manage the camera and receive image streams. Then it will publish to image and point cloud topics using standard ROS message types. It will be able to subscribe to camera control messages and also publish camera status messages. The code for this node will be found in the Royale SDK in the files royale-in-ros.hpp and royale-in-ros.cpp. We'll be visualizing the images we receive using RViz. So the second thing we'll build is a camera control panel in RViz. This lets us publish camera control messages and subscribe for camera status messages. The source for this panel will be located in the Royale SDK at royalecontrol.hpp and royalecontrol.cpp. Here I am on my Ubuntu 20.04 desktop, where I have the Flex2 USB camera connected. I also have the Royale SDK here on my desktop. Inside the Royale SDK, you can find the ROS2 sample files under Samples, CPP, Sample ROS2. Let's take a very quick look at the source code for this sample, starting with the header and CPP file for the camera node. As you can see from this header file, we have a single class called Royale in ROS, which is a node in ROS2. This class is also of type Royale iDepthDataListener and Royale iExposureListener, so it can receive image and status information from the camera. Let's move on to the CPP file. Here, we can see the topics and message types it publishes. We have the camera info, which contains the lens calibration parameters and image resolution, the point cloud, gray, and depth images, and some status information, which includes the exposure time and frame rate. The camera node will also subscribe to some messages in order to configure the camera. The camera node uses the Royale C++ API to manage a camera. So here we can see the Royale camera manager creating an instance of a Royale camera device, which it will use to interface with the camera. The camera node's onNewData method receives an image from the Royale camera device. It then converts this image to standard ROS2 message types and publishes them. Let's now take a very quick look at the header file for the RViz panel. Here we have a single class called Royale Control, which is of type RViz Common Panel. It publishes messages to topics which the camera node receives to control the camera. Through this panel, we can configure the camera's use case, exposure, and range filter. The panel also receives some status messages from the camera node. The last file I will briefly go over is the launch file. This launch file starts two nodes. The first node is a static transform publisher so that we can rotate the point cloud so that the x-axis faces right, the y-axis faces down, and the z-axis faces forward. It uses these yaw, pitch, and roll parameters to rotate the point cloud. And the second node is the camera node itself. So to build this sample, we'll need to create a ROS workspace. So on my desktop, I'll create two directories. The first directory will be the root of the workspace, which I'll name ROS2_WS. The second directory will be inside the ROS2 workspace. So I'll create a new folder here, and I'll name this SRC for source. And in this directory, I'll copy the entire ROS2 sample folder from the Royale SDK. All right, now I have a workspace set up and I can begin building. I'll start by opening a new shell and navigate to my ROS workspace, which I just created on my desktop. And this is the shell I'll use to build the software. Before I continue though, I'll need to configure this shell's environment by setting the ROS2 installation as my underlay. So to do that, I'll source /opt/ros/foxy/setup.sa. I'll then use Colcon to build. So I will call Colcon build, and I need to pass one CMake argument to this build. And the CMake arg that I need to set is the CMake prefix path. And the value for this argument is the path to the share folder within the Royale SDK. This is so CMake can find royale-config.cmake, which helps locate the Royale library and header files. So let's copy this path and paste it as my argument. And then to build, I just hit enter. Okay, it looks like the build was successful. And we should now have three new directories, the build, install, and log directory. So let's now try to run our new ROS2 camera node. The ROS2 documentation recommends that we run in a different shell than the one we used to build. So I'll start a new shell, and I'll navigate to my ROS2 workspace, and I'll configure the ROS environment again. Now, I'll also need to include this workspace to my environment as the overlay, so ROS can find the software we just built. So I can call source install setup.sh. To run the node, I'll call ROS2 launch Royale in ROS2 camera driver dot launch dot py. As you can see from this output, there are two nodes that started. There's the static transform publisher. Also, there is the Royale camera node, which seems to have found the Flex2 camera. Okay, so while I have the node running in this shell, let's start RViz in a new shell. I'll configure this new shell the exact same way I did the last one. Simply to my workspace, set the ROS2 underlay environment, and include the binaries in this package to the environment. And then to start RViz, I'll call ROS2 run RViz2 RViz2. So the first thing I want to do in RViz is to set the fixed frame. And for that, I'll set this to Royale and ROS link. After that, I can start subscribing to some topics. So to do that, I could press the button at the bottom left, add, and I'll add by topic. And under Royale camera, you can see all of the topics and messages that are available from this camera. So let's look at point cloud. As you can see here, we now have a point cloud stream rendered in RViz. I can use my mouse to rotate the camera and zoom in to explore this point cloud. I'm here sitting in front of the camera, and behind me is the ceiling, the wall, and the door. To the left are some options for rendering this point cloud. For example, I can color the points based on an axis. And since I've rotated my point cloud, I want the Z-axis of the camera instead of the fixed frame. So now each point is colored based on the Z distance from the camera. And let's turn off autocomplete value bounds, as the color mapping looks okay right now. Okay, so let's explore another topic. Go to add by topic. And let's check out the depth image. Here is a mono 8-bit gray image, but it's actually a depth image where the brightness of the pixel is determined by the distance of the point from the camera. Now let's add the gray image. Here we can see the gray image, which represents all of the light captured by this camera. Now to control the camera, I can add the panel that we saw earlier. To do that, I press panels, add new panel. And here I can select Royale control. Now, to the bottom left, you'll see a new panel. And in this panel, I can control the camera through the ROS node. I can set the FPS or the use case. I can enable or disable auto exposure. If I disable auto exposure, I can set an exposure time manually, but let's just keep auto exposure on. I can set the filter for the minimum distance or the maximum distance for the pixels which are displayed. And I can also configure the gray divisor, which helps me see the gray image a little bit better. Okay, so that concludes the end of this video. I thank you very much for watching.